weekend, a 51-year-old gunman in Nova Scotia disguised himself as a police officer and went on a 12-hour killing spree, leaving at least 22 people dead, including himself, in the worst shooting in Canadian history. The gunman began the rampage in the beachside town of Portapique. Nearly 13 hours later, he had killed at least 22 people across 30 miles and set 5 buildings and his car on fire. While the police are still searching for a motive, it appeared the attacker knew at least some of his victims, but continued on with the spree at random. Every victim was an adult. The dead included police officers, nurses, and an elementary school teacher. An approximately 150-foot-long siphonophore, a string-like ocean creature made up of clusters of cells that can clone themselves up to thousands of times, was recently found near the coast of Australia. Researchers believe it's the longest ocean creature ever recorded. A research team with the Schmidt Ocean Institute made the discovery. They've set out on a year-long expedition to explore the seas of Australia in the Pacific Ocean.
In April, Matan and I talked to some of our fellow students to see how they were planning on spending their time during quarantine. 2 months later, and now we've checked in with some of our peers who've worked on especially creative projects during these times.
Hi, my name is Claudia. I'm a junior at NHS.
My name is Lucia Dostel. I'm 17 and I'm a senior.
I'm Adam Ives. I'm a musician, composer, and producer.
I'm Jasper Fletcher.
I'm Rowan Perkins. I'm a junior making a coffee table for the living room at my dad's house.
For this quarantine, I created an album called In the Clouds, 11 songs, and it'll be out tomorrow.
I made 2 videos for the NHS film competition, as well as learning graphic design, trying to do more photography.
This is what I've been working on during quarantine, my baby at the moment.
Over quarantine, I've spent a lot of time writing snippets and pieces of songs, trying to develop a sound as a musician and develop something that I can portray myself as a solo artist.
One of the challenges has been finding the time and motivation to paint it and work on it with schoolwork and household chores, but it's really fun to do as well.
Because of like the countless hours that are needed to produce and record and edit and all that kinds of stuff, being in quarantine has definitely really helped me finish my project in time and get all 11 songs on there. So
I will say, for me personally, quarantine has been one of the most difficult experiences I've ever dealt with, mainly just because of the lack of motivation that's come with my schedule just being completely wiped out. It's made it really hard to accomplish things and stay motivated.
Having all the time that I have, doing more solo projects has been, it's been a kind of a challenge, but also definitely a learning experience.
I just think it's really important for everyone to be creating at the moment, because where you could express yourself through like clothing or makeup, you can't really express yourself that way anymore during quarantine. It's kind of hard to. I think it's really helped me be like more content with everything.
Long time ago, I'm lost in
Gus, welcome to Make It Yourself. This week, we're making this. Its original purpose was to hang on the wall for you to put your masks of different members of your family, or maybe dirty or clean masks, but you could really hang whatever you want. So, for this week's project, we'll need a palette, which I found behind Walmart, and 3 hooks. You'll also need some wood glue and a handsaw. I will be using some more complicated tools in this video, but there aren't many cuts, so it should be pretty easy with hand tools. The top is 16 inches long, and so is the back. Each of these pieces on the inside are 4.5 inches long. I just cut the end pieces with a saw because I don't need the whole length. The next step is to cut the pieces. Once you test to see if all your pieces are the correct length, you can glue them together. This is done simply by applying glue to two sides of the small pieces and attaching the two larger pieces at a right angle. Next, I applied finish and attached hooks on the inside. So this is how the final product turned out. I hope you liked it. Thanks for watching. This has been Make It Yourself. Y'all ready for this?
For our final episode this season of The Transcript, the crew and I decided we should do a review of the best moments from the 2019-2020 sports season for Northampton High School. In no particular order, here are the best moments from the school year. First off, we have senior night for the football team against Minichog to top off Booster Week. Minichog was the number 2 ranked team in Western Mass going into the week behind the eventual Division 1 state champions, the Central Guy Golden Eagles. Northampton came into the week confident despite not being favored by Mass Live, as they predicted the score to be 45-41 Minichog victory. Hamp came out strong, busting the door open to a 21-0 lead early in the second quarter. But alas, the high-octane Chog offense woke up as they rattled off two quick scores within a minute, and then scored on the last play of the first half after a timeout by the Hamp coach. Just like that, it was 21-21 and the momentum had swung. They traded touchdowns in the third quarter to end the quarter in a 28-28 tie. The team stalemated through the first 6 minutes of the fourth quarter when Hamp got the ball back and ran a couple of screen passes before they ran a play where Tom Jakes hit Braden Tudrin in stride and Tudrin took it 80 yards to the house.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Go BT. Go BT. Go BT. Let's go.
But Chog drove right back down the field and scored with 38 seconds left. Hamp was up 35-34, and Chog lines up for the two-point conversions. If they convert, they win. But they don't. Ryan Antis broke through the line and stopped them. With everyone else pushing the pile, the ref signaled no good and the whole stadium went berserk. Hamp knocked off undefeated Minichog and clinched a playoff berth on their home field. The students rushed the field after, to cap off the legendary night and to cap off Booster Week. Our next moment is the struggling Hamp boys basketball team almost eking out a victory against Putnam, the 10th best team in the state. The game was never out of arm's reach as both teams never amassed a lead greater than 5 points throughout the entire game. With 5 seconds to go, Putnam was fouled and up by 1, and they went to the free throw line. Putnam hit both the free throws, and Jake Britton inbounded the ball to Jacob Cancel, who drove the ball up the court and heaved a half-court shot as one last rally cry to try and send it to overtime. The ball flew slowly as the den and spectators watched, praying that the ball would go in. And indeed it did. It banked off the backboard and went in. The struggling team was going to overtime against a top 10 team in the state. Although they would go on to lose, it was a great moment and really worthy of mention. Our next moment is the boys indoor track team winning Western Mass at Smith College with an overall score of 93, beating second place Longmeadow by 24.8 points. Shout out to Kobe. A huge performance by Toby Lesperance as he PR'd in his fastest mile with a time of 4:24 to win the 1 mile run convincingly. Other highlights leading Northampton to a convincing victory was Toby again and Tim Jakes coming in first and third respectively in the 2 mile, as well as Hamp coming out on top in the 4x8 relay with a time of 8:39.81. Simon LeClaire also PR'd, winning the 1000 meter with a time of 2:38.63. Our last and certainly not least moment was Amanda Michkowski scoring her 1,000th point against a tough Eastern Mass opponent in Groton Dunstable. Amanda entered the game 7 points away from the milestone after scoring 27 points in an overtime loss a couple nights before against Holyoke. In the third quarter, while 2 points away, Amanda drove left against a tough 1-3-1 defense, and she put a layup in the hoop to get quadruple digits, becoming the 12th person in NHS history to do so. Hamp would go on to lose the game, however, but would finish the year with a very respectable 15-8 record. After looking back on many moments from the fall and winter seasons, we send our remorse to spring athletes who cannot compete this year due to COVID-19. We send double remorse to seniors who won't get their last season ever as high schoolers. Thank you for watching this season of The Transcript. And for the final time, Hamped Up, out.
welcome back to What's Left. This week, we're making cinnamon rolls.
For our ingredients, you'll need 3 cups flour, 3/4 cup warm milk, 1/4 cup melted butter, 1 egg and 1 egg yolk at room temperature, 1/4 cup sugar, 2 and 1/4 teaspoons quick rise yeast, and 3/4 teaspoon salt. First, pour the warm milk into a mixing bowl. Then add the yeast and the sugar. The warmth of the milk helps the yeast activate, and the temperature should feel like warm bath water, not too hot. After this sits for about a minute, add the egg and the butter. Then add your flour and salt. Mix this until just combined, and switch to a dough hook on your mixer. Beat the dough for around 5 minutes. Then take a big bowl and coat it with olive oil. Take your dough out. If it's really sticky, flour your hands and make the dough into a ball. Drop this into your bowl and coat it with the oil. Put plastic wrap over the bowl and then a warm wet towel. Let this sit for an hour or until the dough doubles in size. Now flour a cutting board and start rolling out your dough. It should be around 9 by 14 inches, but it doesn't have to be perfect. Then take 1/4 cup softened butter and rub it into your dough. Mix 1.5 tablespoons of cinnamon and 2/3 cup brown sugar and rub this into the dough as well. Now you can start to roll up your dough. Roll from the shorter end into a log, which should be around 9 inches long. My dough ended up being really long, so I just pushed it together into a shorter shape. Then you can cut the dough into rolls. You should have around 9. Cut off the ends of the log first though, because they will be too small to be rolls. Now put your rolls into a 9x9 inch pan with buttered parchment paper. Cover this with plastic wrap and a warm wet towel. Let them rise again for 30 minutes. Then place them in the oven at 350 degrees for 20 minutes. While the rolls bake, we'll make the frosting. You'll need 3/4 cup powdered sugar, 4 ounces of room temperature cream cheese, 3 tablespoons softened butter, and a 1/2 teaspoon vanilla extract. First, beat your butter and cream cheese until fluffy. Then add the vanilla and sugar. Put this into a bowl and refrigerate until use. Take your cinnamon rolls out of the oven when they get golden brown around the edges. You don't want to overbake these. Let cool for 10 minutes and then frost. Enjoy your delicious cinnamon rolls.
Okay, so welcome everybody. How you doing? Alexa!
Sorry, I'm late, Jeremy. I was just...
What? Nah, it's all good. I'm just kidding. All right, y'all. Strap in, because we're looking at the exposure triangle over here. So, so if you can see, we'll just quickly share that. Excuse me.
Jeremy.
Why do you have Timothy Chalamet on your screen? Jeremy.
Guys, exposure triangle. Stay focused, please.
Is that a joke?
Fiona, can you name one piece of the enclosure triangle? Okay. So, yep, continue going. Sounds like a wonderful answer that we can't hear because of mute. Wow, now we have a pyromaniac over here. Yeah. I mean, I guess that I've seen more unsafe things in my own classroom, so, you know what? Fire safety is an important lesson to learn in your house.
My house burnt down once.
Matan, what is the second piece of the exposure triangle? Matan! M-A-T.
Hey.
Hey, what's the second part?
Bro, if Ross and Rachel don't end up together, it's gonna be the worst quarantine ever.
First off, get off your phone. Second off, I 100% agree. You are so right, and plus 5 points.
You know what, Jeremy, I can answer that question for you.
Okay. So, go ahead. And mute it. Oh, we'll see if you can...
Essentially what Cheddar's is.
Yeah. You know what? I can read lips sometimes. That looked like it was good.
Hi, Grandma. Yeah, no, I'm just a stupid call with my class. No, we're not doing anything. We're just kind of sitting here. Yeah, no, I'll just take this, and then my teacher...
Oh, really?
You're a bitch. Jesus
Christ. Language!
I'm sorry!
Charlie, who was that?
My grandma.
Really? Because I thought it was somebody that you were calling for the next answer. You're up.
I cannot do this right now.
Oh, God. Okay, so back on track. The third one over here. So, Lucas, can you tell me the third part of the exposure triangle, please? Please.
Oh, that's easy, Jeremy. The camera on the triangle. Most of the time. A triangle.
Okay, you know what? I'm just gonna mute him, so he's good. What are you making over there, Gus? Yeah.
Jeremy, you lent me a camera and I dropped it.
Oh, well, I mean, don't worry about it. It's just taxpayer dollars, so we'll get some more later, so don't worry about it.
I would expect that.
What you should do, though, is we might be able to do some fraud, so don't...
With a special report from a Bernie Sanders rally.
My mama called, see you on TV, sunset done change. Ever since we was on, I dreamed it all. Ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing, look, we made it. Yeah, we made it. That was never friendly, yeah. Now I'm jumping out the Bentley, yeah. And I know I sound dramatic, yeah. But I know I had to have it, yeah. For the money, I'm a savage, yeah. I be itching like I had it, yeah. I'm surrounded 20 bags, yeah. But they didn't know me.